Hi everyone, this is going to be another skincare video, this time for skincare tips and information for people with oily or combination skin. So the first video I did was for people with dry skin and how to problem solve that skin issue, and I got pretty good feedback on that. I will be doing makeup versions of these skincare videos, so makeup that's good for people with different types of skin. So stay tuned for that if you are interested in this skin talk series. But for this, we are going to focus on skincare for people with oily or combination skin and do's and don'ts and sort of breaking a lot of myths that surround what you should be doing for oily skin problems. Alright, so if you're interested, please stick around and please take the time to subscribe to this channel if you are interested in these videos. And as always, there is a link to the blog sale in the description box. And let's go! So the most common wrong strategy for taking care of oily or combination skin is to try to dry it out. And that actually doesn't do anything to lessen the oil production of your skin, and in fact can encourage the skin to produce more oil later on. So don't take the route of trying to scrub your skin off or dry it off really severely. That's not good for your skin and it doesn't solve the problem. How much oil your skin produces is determined by your hormones, which are in turn determined pretty much entirely by genetics. And so it's not something that you can control by doing something to the surface of your skin. And so doing those kinds of things, like really scrubbing at it or trying to use drying agents on it, doesn't actually affect the cause of the oil that's coming out from underneath the skin. So don't use overly drying products, things like bar soaps. Even bar soaps that say they're moisturizing are too drying on the skin. Don't use bar soaps. The second thing is don't use other really drying ingredients, like some cleansers, you know, you use them and they're so slick and they just strip everything out of your skin. And once you dry off your skin starts to like shrivel up, you can just feel it. Avoid those kinds of products also. Two, avoid products with alcohol in them. Now, a lot of people tend to sort of be drawn toward things with alcohol in it because initially it does seep the moisture out of the skin, and people confuse that with getting oil out of the pores. But it's, again, not a long-term solution. You also want to avoid things that are tingling to the skin. Now, this is not unique to people with oily skin. This is for all people, dry, normal, oily skinned. That tingling sensation, a lot of people have come to associate because of marketing with some sort of cleansing idea, and that's not true. The tingling is your skin reacting and being irritated by some ingredients. So common ingredients that cause that irritation are things like menthol, a lot of times lemon agents, and things like mint or eucalyptus. So stay away from those kinds of ingredients. And as always, I'm probably gonna say in every video, no matter what kind of skin type you have, don't buy skincare or makeup for that matter that has fragrance in it. Fragrance is not skincare. Fragrance doesn't do anything positive for the skin, and instead it's actually an irritant to the skin. So avoid fragrance in your makeup and your skincare products. All right, so as I do for each skincare video, I will go through pretty much sequentially what someone's skincare routine would be, and I will make general suggestions about what you should get for that skincare category, and then I will give you practical, real examples of the types of products that would be good to use. So first, of course, would be cleaning the skin. Now, you want something that cleans effectively, but like I mentioned before, something that doesn't strip too heavily on the skin so that it feels really tight right after you've dried the skin off. The two products that I am currently using, one I just finished up, which you'll see in my upcoming empties video, is by Trader Joe's. If you have a Trader Joe's near you, they have a Nourish line, and this is the all-in-one facial cleanser. It's great because it has antioxidants in it, but it doesn't have fragrance and it doesn't have irritating ingredients. And it has a formula that lathers enough to effectively clean the skin without leaving it feeling really dry afterward. And it's very affordable. I think it's $4 or $5. So definitely a good investment. I think this is my second empty bottle now of this. Once that ran out, I went back to something I had been using before for review purposes, and this is by Etopalm. This is their Moisturizing Facial Cleansing Foam. And this says on the bottle that it's for dry and sensitive skin, but it definitely, I think, takes the oils off the skin enough that it would be great for oily combination skin people as opposed to people with dry skin. But in any case, it has a foam formula to it, and it also doesn't have fragrance in it, and it effectively cleans the skin without leaving it too stripped. This isn't one of my favorite products. It's not something that I would repurchase, but it just happens to be what I have next to my sink right now, using for my oily and combination skin. But really, the practical examples are numerous for cleansers. Just take something that cleans effectively without having fragrance in it or any irritating ingredients in it. For toners, the number one thing I think to avoid, again, as I mentioned in all videos, because this applies to people with all skin types, is the alcohol. For some reason, skincare companies, majority of them put alcohol in their toners because people associate the term toning with some sort of astringent quality, and so that has kind of become the trend. But alcohol is not a good thing for your skin. Studies are showing more, I think, more and more now. It's not 100% nailed down, but it's not going to help your skin, so why buy something that is very likely damaging to the skin when it doesn't have any sort of countering benefits for your skin? So avoid the alcohol. And in any case, when you strip the skin with an agent like that, it can actually encourage the skin to produce oil afterwards. So there's really no reason to get a toner with alcohol, or any skincare for that matter that has alcohol in it. And you don't want something that's too emollient or moisturizing in your toner. Now, this typically isn't a problem, again, because there's pretty much no really, really moisturizing toner out there. So this is not a huge thing that you have to worry about. But if there happens to be some toner that you know of that is very moisturizing, then you want to avoid that as someone with oily or combination skin. Two examples, something that I've shown in videos before. This is Michael Todd's Cranberry Anti-Ox Hydrating Anti-Aging Toner. And it says hydrating. It is not stripping or not drying for sure, but it's not extra emollient or moisturizing by any means. So this is good because it also has antioxidants in it. It doesn't have other irritating ingredients. This is not an endorsement of Michael Todd across the board, because this line does have toners and other skincare. Most of the skincare actually in the Michael Todd line contains ingredients that are not that great for the skin. So this is sort of a narrow endorsement for this product specifically. And then Paula's Choice, pretty much anything in her line, any of those toners will work for you. She does have a couple that say they're for dry to very dry skin, which are more repairing toners. Even those can work for people with oily skin, but she has plenty of ones for normal skin or all skin types, or particular to oily and combination skin that you can use. So next I'm going to talk about exfoliating. Now this, depending on what kind of exfoliating you're doing, wouldn't sequentially come at this point. It would come while you're cleansing if you are using a manual exfoliant, so something that is physically abrading the skin or exfoliating the skin. But if you are using a chemical exfoliant, so something that has BHAs or AHAs in it, or in other words, salicylic acid in it, or alpha hydroxy in it, then those are chemical exfoliants for the skin. If you're using a manual exfoliator, the thing to remember is to buy something that has exfoliating beads, I guess you would call them, or the physical exfoliants that are smooth and uniform in shape. So to illustrate what I'm trying to communicate, I will give you a counter example. An example of something you should avoid is something that has things like nutshell powder in it. One of the most commonly endorsed or raved about physical exfoliants or scrubs on YouTube, especially in the beauty community, is St. Ives Apricot Scrub. That is not a good scrub for your skin. It takes the shells of apricot seeds, grinds them up, and puts that in the scrub as the exfoliating agent. But the powder isn't even, so it's scratching the skin, which is actually damaging the skin, instead of using a smooth surface that sort of, it's hard to explain, but sort of rolls across the skin to remove the dead skin cells. You want something smooth so that you are removing the dead skin cells on top of the skin without scratching at it. And so that's why you want to avoid things that have like walnut shell powder or apricot seed powder. And you want to use something like St. Ives green tea scrub. So not saying St. Ives should be avoided in every case, but just that apricot scrub that I mentioned. And sorry this one is so dirty, but this is the one that I use a lot of the time. So this is what it looks like. And the granules in this physical exfoliant or scrub are uniform and smooth in this on the surface. So it will nicely exfoliate the skin and make it smooth without simultaneously damaging the skin. As for a chemical exfoliant, there are a couple of different kinds, but for oily skin, one of the most helpful one is an exfoliant that has BHA in it, or more commonly it's called salicylic acid. And people who deal with acne and buy a lot of over-the-counter acne products are probably familiar with that active ingredient, salicylic acid. What salicylic acid has over other chemical exfoliants when it comes to people with oily skin is that it actually goes beneath the surface of the skin. It doesn't just sit on the surface of the skin, it goes into the pore and then helps the oil in the pore come out of the pore more easily. So that's kind of why you want to try to get an exfoliant that has salicylic acid in it to help with the sort of releasing all that oil from the pore. So an example of a chemical exfoliant is by Paula's Choice. This is from her Clear line, which is her anti-acne line. And this is the anti-redness exfoliating solution, and it has 2% salicylic acid. And it is a liquid formula, so you just put it on a cotton pad and put it on, you know, whatever affected areas. So if you're very oily in the T-zone, then you would put it on there. And so this kind of doubles up as sort of a toner that's also anti-acne, that is also helping with people with oily skin. So this is a great product to try out. And Paula's Choice has promos that go on all the time. She has different ones. So if you're interested in keeping up to date, I do a weekly This Week's Beauty Sales and Deals post. They usually get published on Sunday night. So if you want to know what the beauty sales and deals are, including the deals that Paula Choice runs, then you can look that post. I will also try to remember to put a link in the description box for you with the current promotion that is going on. So next you would apply a moisturizer. Now if you're doing this in the daytime, then of course you would want a moisturizer that has sun protection in it, both for UVA and UVB rays. So first I will talk about basically sunscreens that you could be using. Now it's easy to find a lot of sunscreens that have that sunscreeny, oily, slick finish, and of course if you have oily skin or combination skin, you want to avoid that like the plague. It's more difficult to find things that sunscreens that are mattifying and not don't have a sheen to their finish, but that don't use alcohol to achieve that more matte finish. And so this is kind of a more difficult area, but I will make a couple suggestions for you. The absolute number one suggestion would be the Resist line, this is again from Paula's Choice, Resist line SPF 30 moisturizing cream. Now I've talked about this in previous videos because this particular packaging was phased out. They still have this formula, you just have to kind of search for this. It's in the face or sunscreen line, and it is now, used to be a hand cream. So it used to be called the Ultimate Anti-Aging Hand Cream. They sort of took this from the hand cream line and put it into the moisturizer category, and then they substituted this hand cream with a different formula. So just know that this, it won't have the same packaging if you purchase this on the website, but it is the moisturizer for, that comes in this kind of bottle, and it has an SPF of 30. This is moisturizing while simultaneously not leaving an oily slick. This, you would never know that there was sunscreen in this, particularly with an SPF of 30. Because it has such a beautiful finish. It doesn't have any oiliness, it's not thick and goopy like a lot of sunscreens or moisturizers with sunscreen in them can be. So this is a fantastic choice for people with oily and combo skin. Another great option is, surprisingly, by Neutrogena. I say surprisingly because a ton of their stuff has bad ingredients in it, but the sort of liquid sheer sunscreens that they have in these bottles that come like this and that you shake up. This line has a few different SPF levels, and they're a really thin liquid, and they're absolutely just not, they don't create that oily slick that you get with sunscreens typically, which is amazing because a lot of these have a pretty high SPF, and usually when you get higher and higher up in the SPF, you get more and more of that like white cast and kind of oily texture, but these don't do that. I use these all the time when I do outdoor activities like outdoor climbing or running or hiking because they are so thin and kind of like really sink into the skin without making it look like a slick. So this one is the Pure and Free Liquid Sunscreen. And this one is my favorite. It's even better. It's the Ultra Sheer Liquid Sunscreen with an SPF of 55. Unfortunately, they have discontinued this particular one. They still have a few other options in this kind of formulation of sunscreen. So this is definitely still available. And then they have a different, you know, a couple different SPF levels in them. But you can probably still find this one somewhere online. You won't be able to find it in the drugstores though. So next, if you were going to use a nighttime moisturizer, or sometimes you of course could put on a non-SPF moisturizer for skincare purposes before you apply your sunscreen. But in any case, next I'm going to talk about moisturizers that don't have sun protection in them. So for those kinds of moisturizers, whether they have sunscreen or not in them, usually people with oily skin, combination skin, will fare better with avoiding heavy creams, thick creams, or thick lotion formulas. If you opt for something that has a liquid formula or a gel formula, it's going to be a lot less shiny and help keep the, you know, shininess and oiliness away for longer than if you use something that's really emollient and really thick. So a great example of a gel formula moisturizer that doubles as skincare because it has AHA in it is from Paul's Choice, the Skin Perfecting AHA Gel. And I know I show a ton of Paul's Choice stuff. This is all mine. I purchased all of this. I have never been sent free products from Paul's Choice and been endorsed by them. I wish I were, but I'm not. So the reason why I suggest this all the time because it's pretty much the only skincare line that consistently, every single time, will not put irritating ingredients for your skin in the skincare, like fragrance or alcohol or things that give you that tingle. So that's why it's very easy for me to always recommend these products because I know that they're not going to contain those bad for you ingredients. But anyway, back to this moisturizer. So you see that it's this clear liquid consistency. Blend very quickly over the skin, and once it kind of sets and dries, you see that there's just no sheen at all, so it's not going to exacerbate any sort of oiliness that you have. An example of a liquid form moisturizer. Now, these are not common. I think this is probably the only one that I know about. Again, from Paul's Choice, sorry. The Resist line, this is the Vitamin C Booster. It's called the C15 Super Booster, and it comes with a drop dispenser. And as you can see, it is a liquid formula. Now, I wouldn't just use this for my face. I would add it into another moisturizer, but this is an example of something that, because of its formula, is not going to exacerbate any oiliness that you have. So the last thing you would apply if you use serums is a face serum, and this would be probably at nighttime. Although I will give you a suggestion for something that I use in the daytime all the time. And this is a more difficult thing for people with oily skin to be able to use because typically serums are more oily and they have a texture that leaves a lot of shine to them. But if you are someone who really wants to be able to use a serum, although I guess if you're using it at nighttime, no one's gonna see you, you're gonna apply it before you go to bed. And if you are sleeping next to someone, hopefully that person is not judging how oily your skin is. But in any case, if you want something that doesn't make your skin look even more oily, here are two options for you. From Paula Choice's Resist line, this is the Ultralight Super Antioxidant Concentrate Serum. So very easy to identify because the whole brand is split up into oily, normal, dry combo products. So it says right here on the packaging that it's for oily skin. It is a much lighter weight serum than a lot of serums that you might otherwise find on the market. But another serum that is actually quite mattifying instead of just being non-oily is by Paula's Choice again. This is the Skin Balancing Mattifying Concentrate Serum. And what's great about this one is it kind of has a silicone-like texture, and it definitely helps temporarily mattify the skin. And the bonus, of course, in this is that it has retinol in it, so you get that skincare boost. But this is a fantastic option and pretty much the only serum that I know about that is actually actively mattifying for people who have shine problems with their skin. And last up, kind of miscellaneous, this is not technically skincare, but it is more non-makeup than makeup, so I'm gonna put it in this video, are oil absorbers. So I don't know where mine is right now, but Paula's Choice does have a anti-shine product. It comes in a long kind of brownish taupe-ish tube, and again has a slight silicone feel. It has dimethicone in it, so it does give you a temporary mattifying effect. And you know what? Honestly, the best option for people with oily skin to get rid of the oiliness throughout the day is to use blotting papers. I have a ton of the e.l.f. blotting papers. There's no reason to buy super expensive blotting papers. They are the same. Paying $30 for blotting papers is not going to remove the oil from your skin more effectively. These work great. They don't mess your makeup off, they don't mess up your makeup, so you can just use them and to absorb the oil even if you are wearing makeup. They're $1 each, and so you get 50 sheets for $1, 2 cents a sheet. A great option for getting rid of that oiliness throughout the day. And I think it's important to note that even products that are oil absorbing, they're not going to work unless you have very minimal oiliness or oiliness is not actually that big of a problem for you. They're not going to keep oil at bay for the entire day. You will have to blot the oil away somehow, or, you know, if you are the person who prefers to add powder on the face, or somehow manually get rid of the oil. It doesn't matter how much the packaging for whatever you're buying says keeps you oil-free for 24 hours or 18 hours or whatever the claim is. It just, the products don't work that way because those are things you're putting on top of the skin. The oil comes from underneath the skin. So it doesn't matter how great of a product it is, you're not solving the problem. You can't stop your body from physically producing the oil on your face just by putting something on top of the face. So I guess I mentioned that A, to let you know, don't give into this hype or this false claim that something is going to keep you oil-free for 24 hours, because unless it's doing something really funky, it's just not actually physically possible to do that if your skin produces a lot of oil normally. So don't go spending $75 on something because it says that it's going to do that. It's not. And I guess the second reason I mention it is just to help you give in to the fact, or like accept the fact, that the oil blotting process is going to need to happen at some point during the day, perhaps several times a day, and to be okay with that. You know, spend $1 and get 50 blotting papers and take 5 seconds to blot your face and, you know, get rid of that oiliness. All right, I hope that was helpful for you. I will as quickly as possible given all these other videos that I'm trying to do makeup counterparts to these so that you can have some ideas of what to look for in makeup products that are good for people with different kinds of skin types. I really enjoy making these kinds of videos. Skincare is kind of my thing along with makeup, but I particularly like the science behind skincare. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video and I hope it helps you out. I hope it makes you feel more confident about how to arm yourself with knowledge to determine what products to avoid and what claims to say, hey, that is totally a bogus claim, and conversely to help you have the knowledge to know which products to look for and which ingredients to look for. All right, thanks for taking the time to watch this video. I'll see you in the next one.